In 1831, cholera first arrived in the UK from ships in Hebden docks. Are we ready today?
As a British man becomes the first UK citizen to die from coronavirus.
If I had to take bets, I would want to be in the United Kingdom more than I want to be in most other places.
If I had to take bets, I would want to be in the United Kingdom more than I want to be in most other places.
Everything will be done to keep people as safe as possible, okay? It has not yet spread in the UK. These cases are people who have come from areas where it has spread, and that is very different. So there's no better time or no better place to be, really.
And Kate, from your perspective as an economics correspondent, how do we get the judgment right about what it is worth stopping doing, like sporting fixtures being postponed or schools not opening, where there might be an immediate economic consequence of that?
The economic consequence can be major. We have to remember that, well, public health is obviously on our mind. When you have turndowns in global growth and the rest, that has a real human impact as well. We must be cautious not to overreact.
And we see today that there has been a 13% fall in the value of the FTSE 100 index over the course of this week.
Look, I think you're right to ask that question in terms of how ready we are. I think people look at recent things that have happened, like the floodings, and so there are some questions about how prepared we are. But from what I can see, people are coming together. It's very important that we work together, that the political parties and people act together, because these sorts of things that people can't see coming, they test our infrastructure. You know, and I would agree that we do need to make sure that we are proportional in our action, that we don't, you know, absolutely just panic. But there's a lot to be concerned about.
I turn over in my own mind the question, are we prepared and how do we respond? And I don't know whether to be reassured or terrified that Boris Johnson's going to chair a Cobra committee on Monday. But I also find it odd that schools are shutting. And I just think that's a massive overreaction. And let's just bear in mind that over the last 5 years, an average of 17,000 people in Britain have died from flu. And we got one death now, and I just think we may, the reaction may be inflicting the damage in the economy and creating the panic. And now I think what we probably should all do is, yes, hope the government is preparing, fearing the worst, hoping for the best. But what we could all do as individuals is stay calm, wash our hands and carry on.
Isn't the logic, though, of that argument that it's actually a good thing that Boris Johnson hasn't been chairing Cobra meetings, because that would give a sense of, oh goodness, there's a crisis.
Are the older members of the audience, and I'm one of them, brave or foolish to come here tonight?
I came here because, as far as I know, the virus is not circulating anywhere in the UK, and it's certainly not circulating in Horsham, so...
As far as I know, the virus is not circulating anywhere in the UK, and it's certainly not circulating in Horsham, so, you know, no prob.